محمد على الدعوة، والشكر موصول للدكتور عبد الله الفواز وجميع الزملاء. طبعا يعني الساعة هذه بتكون أكثرها زي ما تكون مناقشة أكثر منها محاضرة ولا formal lecture، لأن الهدف منها بس إنه we break some fears about getting your work published and how you get it published. طبعا تجربتي بسيطة، بس بحاول أشارككم شوي من التجربة وأشياء تعلمتها، فكويس يعني كويس إنه إذا أحد له رغبة يستفيد منها، والجميع بالخير، والخير في الجميع، والخير بالجميع إن شاء الله. قبل ما نبدأ، بس إنه أحتاج أتكلم، بس إنه يعني writing a manuscript is a process، يعني مو بس أكتبها مرة وخلاص أقفل المانوسكريبت ما راح أرجع مرة ثانية. But it's a continuous process. When you start by writing it. Then after that, you go and start building it and slowly, and you go and see how is it. Then you submit it to, or you give it to your mentor or your supervisor. They will add on it. Then you give it to them. Then they will add more and more. Then after that, you go and submit it to the journal. They will add some comments and try to edit. Then they'll give it back to you. It's a dynamic process. The process starts by the start of your writing manuscript and end by submission of your work, but it's not going to be the end. That's the start of your first publication. So you need to start another process for another publication. And sometimes after you get your work published, some people will write a comment or they have a question about your work. So you have to go back and answer their comments if it's come through the journal itself. So manuscript writing is a process. It's not just like one step and that's it. And the process is like a cycle, and if time you need to go back and do and add and so on. واضح الصوت محمد؟
واضح يا بروف. بالنسبة لي واضح. Everyone else, the voice is clear. If yes, say yes or thumb up in the chat, please. Everyone is saying yes. I can hear yes from everyone. Yeah, go ahead.
طبعا the outline of this session will be about what's manuscript writing, about talk a little bit about the structures. Then after that, we'll talk about some issues related to the manuscript, like plagiarism and also the journal selection. First, when you write a manuscript, you need to start by the introduction. Sometimes you need to write the abstract, but usually I like writing the abstract at the end after writing the introduction and the body of the manuscript and so on. So abstract is the last thing to write. And this is the way I use. So some people, they start with abstract, but for me, it's really, really good to start with the introduction. طبعاً الintroduction, it's by its name, it's introducing what the research you are doing is about and why you are choosing it and how did it go. So it should be like an opening statement to your reader in a way that you attract them to read your work, and with the explanation about your topic by giving a background about what you are writing and why you are writing it. And also you need to be really using a simple language that deliver the message without complicating the issue. When you write in the introduction, it's good not to go in details. It's just an introduction to what you are doing. فما تخش في like a lot of literature discussion وأشياء زي هذه. هذه تكون عادة في ال discussion part. فالintroduction معظم الجورنال حاليا تبغاها تكون قصيرة، بس تبين الأشياء المهم ذكرها في البداية عشان الناس تقرأ الارتكل حقك أو تكمل قراءته. فهذا الشيء مرة مهم إن الانترودكشن ما تكون طويلة، خاصة إنه معظم المعلومات مفروض ما تطلع في الانترودكشن، معظم المعلومات مفروض تجي في الريزلت والديسكشن. فالانترودكشن بس مجرد إنه something to attract people to write you to read your article. بالنسبة للميثودز، طبعاً الميثودز طبعاً لها تختلف من study لstudy depends on what you have done. بس في أشياء معينة مهمة تذكرها في كل ميثود، وأهمها حالياً is ethical consideration. فهل in your method what ethical consideration have you done? هذا من ناحية. من ناحية الشيء الثاني، have you got the IRB approval؟ هل كان في special form need to be taken from patient like consent or etc. إذا كان في فرضا animal study، هل أخذت البركوشن بشكل كامل ولا لا؟ فهذه أشياء مهمة تكون واضحة في الميثود. الشيء الثاني بالنسبة للميثود، كويس يكون فيها الانكلوجن والإكسكلوجن كريتيريا عشان الناس تعرف السكوب حق الستادي كان based on which sample and how the sample was chosen. بعدها يجي details of بعض الأحيان أنت you're doing randomized clinical trials، فيحتاج تفصل كيف الترايل randomization صار وكيف الترايل process of choosing نفس السامبل والإنديفيدوال في الترايل والإفاليويشن والإفاليويشن ميثودز. فتختلف من دراسة إلى دراسة writing the description of the method. إذا كان retrospective، how did you collect the data، how did you reach to the to your sample and how was your selection in this sample، فهذه تحتاج details، خاصة إذا كان في surgical procedure. بعض الأحيان الناس we report a retrospective or a prospective في فرضا outcome of fatal resection، نتكلم عن التوسس فرضا، يحتاج تذكر in details your surgical procedure إذا كان الهدف الأساسي من الستادي نفسها presenting a new procedure or modification of an old procedure. فهذه يحتاج كمان تفصل بطريقة واضحة details of the procedure، وش كان pre-op care والpost op care والoutcome وhow you define your outcome. فهذا المكان إنه توضح بشكل كامل بحيث الناس تعرف إنه what method have you used to evaluate your sample and based on what you come to your result. بالنسبة للresults، الresults مرة مهم إنك you mention not only the positive also the negative findings، لأنه really important for people to know when they do a similar study what are the positive and negative finding that you find in your study. لأنه بعض الأحيان negative finding ممكن أنت ما تحسها مهمة لكن بالنسبة للreader تكون مهمة، فكويس تعرف what are the important negative and positive finding need to be presented in the result. طبعا بالنسبه للريزلت لازم يكون لها ثيم، يعني تكون فلوينت. فلما تذكر ريزلت تذكر فزم تتكلم عن الايج والجندر، بعدين شوي شوي تكون تتكلم عن ديتيلز اوف ذا ريزلت. فكويس انها تكون سموث ويكون الترانزيشن في الريزلت سموث، ما يكون فيه يعني ريزلت تتكلم مره عن البري اوب وبعدين ترجع تتكلم بوست اوب وبعدين ترجع مره ثانيه تتكلم عن بري اوب. فكويس تكون فلوينت وتكون سموث البرزنتيشن حق الريزلت. بعض الاحيان وهذا مره كويس انا اشوفه تستخدم انه تو بريزنت يور ريزلت، كويس انه تستخدم تيبلز وفيجرز، هذه تسهل للناس معرفه الريزلت. لما تكون فيجوال ريزلت تيبلز ولا فيجرز الناس تفهمها بشكل افضل وذي كان بروسس ات ودايجست بشكل افضل. بعض الاحيان لما يكون التكست مكتوب بكل الريزلت في التكست تكون صعبه على الناس. طبعا من الاشياء اللي تسال دائما اذا كتبت الريزلت اذا كانت الريزلت موجوده في التيبل وفي الفيجر هل احتاج اعيدها في التكست ولا لا؟ الشيء المهم يحتاج ينعاد في التكست. اذا اشياء ما هي مره كريتيكال ومو مره مهمه ممكن بس في الريزلت presented as a table of figures تكون كويسه، لكن الكي بوينت ريزلت كويس ان تعاد كتابتها او صياغتها في الريزلت. السبب الرئيسي من الشيء هذا انه الناس تعرف الشيء المهم وتقدر وتنتبه له بشكل افضل، وهذا يساعد لما تسوي الدسكشن انه نفس القارئ يكون عنده فكره عن الريزلت اللي قاعد تسوي لها دسكشن انت خلال الدسكشن بار. الدسكشن از ذا مين بارت، هذا المكان اللي تظهر فيه فعلا مهاره المانسكريبت رايتنج. طبعا في الدسكشن يحتاج اشياء كثيره ان تحطها في بالك لما تكتب الدسكشن. من اهم الاشياء انه وهذا فعلا الاساسي في الدسكشن انه you discuss or interpreted your finding in relation to the published data or research. But for which, what was the what did you find in your research, or what you have found in your research, and what other people found similar or different? And in the discussion, you elaborate more on that and try to find why the similarity present and why the difference is present. وهذا الشيء ضروري إنه you explain it in details. بعد ما you discuss it in details, you need to present the strength of your study along with the limitation of the method you use for in your study and your discussion. The discussion should include all the things that you think it's positive in your study and limit your study from being bitter. وهذا شيء معروف إنه ما في study is complete and there is a limitation in each study. But it's good to and present it in a way that it doesn't let the people underestimate your study. It's more of saying, okay, this is a like a step in reaching further conclusion or further understanding of the disease you are presenting or the process you are talking about. شيء مهم ثاني يتناقش عادة في الدسكشن is can your finding be generalized to other population, وهذه مرة مهم. يعني إذا سويت دراسة في السعودية هل هذا ينطبق على كل الـ population في مختلف العالم, أو أنه في أشياء خاصة فرضا في السعودية limit the result from being or the finding being generalized for example in Asia or Africa or elsewhere. فهذا شيء مرة مهم أنه يتناقش من ناحية الـ widespread of your result. نقطة ثانية في الدسكشن إنه you need to highlight إنه your research وش الأشياء اللي ممكن ينبني على your research and what can be done further to زي ما قلنا قبل شوي إنه to come with better outcome or better understanding in your in the disease you are discussing. بعض الأحيان لما تسوي فرضنا retrospective study وتلاحظ بعض الأشياء limitation في retrospective study, وهذه كثيرة يعني being a retrospective study this is one of the limitation. فأنت ممكن تقترح والله in a future study you can do it in randomized clinical trials take in consideration 1 and 2 and 3. It depends on your study that you are presenting and your result. نقطة أخيرة وهذه ضرورية تذكر في الdiscussion إنه what implication of your study and the practice in people reading your article? فهل هي you recommend them to change their practice based on your result ولا لا? If you are recommending them, why you are recommending them? And if you are not recommending them, you need to explain why that happened. فكويس في الدسكشن تغطي الأشياء هذه. طبعاً الدسكشن هو الشيء الأساسي اللي فيه مساحة حرة أنت تقدر تتكلم فيها وتظهر فيها رأيك. فرضا في الانترودكشن مو مكان تظهر فيه رأيك. في الميثود والريزلت مفروض انه facts you are just presenting. في الدسكشن هو هذا المكان اللي تعرض فيه رأيك وتعرض الطريقة علمية by discussing the briefest publication, your import, your positive and negative results in a smooth and productive way during the discussion part. لما تخلص الدسكشن you will reach for the conclusion. طبعا الconclusion لازم تكون concise و clear statement فيها وواضحة والobjective حق your study presented with the main outcome. بالإضافة كويس in the conclusion you rephrase your recommendation for if you are changing a clinical practice ولا لا. كمان في الconclusion كويس you highlight and what's further need to be done regarding the area you are presenting your study about. فتعطيك اختصار يعني لو أقرأ الconclusion يكون عندي انطباع وش كانت study عنه وش الشيء اللي ممكن ينبني من خلال study هذه. فالconclusion على قولتهم تعطيك الزبدة. طبعا when you write المانسكريبت you write it in paragraphs. والparagraphs كويس إنه يكون فيها شوي main guideline تأخذ بالاعتبار عندما تكتب الباراجراف. فالباراجراف تعتبر يسمونها كيونت in the text. واليونت it has different sentences. فبالبداية تكون you should start with a sentence that it has a topic that outline the first sentence. في الأول أول sentence تكون عبارة introducing sentence. بعدين تجي بعدها different sentences that we call it developed or main body sentences. بعدين بالأخير تكون في sentence تسميها terminating sentence عشان تختصر الباراجراف هذا يتكلم عن إيش. فكويس كل باراجراف يكون لها فكرة معينة, والفكرة معينة تطرح بطريقة مقدمة, بعدين main bulk, بعدين زي ما تقول conclusion للباراجراف هذا, عشان الريدر يكون يمشي وينتقل بسلاسة من باراجراف إلى الباراجراف آخر, وتكون الأفكار متسلسل بشكل سلس وسهل الفهم للقارئ. طبعا الباراجراف لازم يحتوي زي ما قلنا على some evidence that what the paragraph is talking about. غير كذا ضروري يكون في citation, لان ما مو كويس الباراجراف تكتبه كله من كلامك, خاصه لما نتكلم على introduction ولا discussion. خلال الباراجراف تحط comment على الافيدنس اللي ذكرتها, سواء study من article ولا من book ولا غيره. كويس انه you contrast and present your let's say comments and argument about the publication you mentioned or the what you have cited from previous studies. طبعا في writing الباراجراف كويس يكون فيها نسميها signpost, يعني كلمات تربط الجمل مع بعض, بس كويس تستخدم بمهنيه او بحرافه in a scientific way. مو كويس تكثر منها كثير, لانه لما تكثر من signpost الريدر get confused. فكويس تستخدمها in appropriate way ولا بحاجه مقبوله, بحيث تربط لك ال sentences مع بعض. من الاشياء اللي تستخدم بكثره ممكن تتكلم for example, however, moreover, etc. فكويس تستخدم بطريقه انها تربط الجمل لكن ما تفرط استخدامها, عشان بس ال doesn't confuse ال reader بشكل كبير. شيء آخر من ناحية ال paragraph لازم يكون clear. ومن أهم الأشياء اللي أشوفها كويس لما you write a paragraph, كويس إن يكون عندك تصور عن ال paragraph كم يكون حجمه. مو كويس ال paragraph يكون طويل ولا كويس يكون قصير. فغالبا لما يكون في ال paragraph تقريبا 4 to 5 sentences يعتبر معقول جدا حجمه. أكثر من كذا يكون ممل بالنسبة للقارئ يقرأ أو يعرف الفكرة من الباراجراف هذا. شيء مهم ثاني, لما تكتب نفس السنتنس كويس ما تكون طويلة. مو كويس تكون أطول من 15 كلمة, لأنه أطول من 15 كلمة صعبة على القارئ أنه يعرف السنتنس هذا وش كان الهدف منها, فجت confused. فكويس أنه تكون appropriate size, it's not that long and that not that short, so the message or the idea will be delivered in a smooth, nice way. كثير من الأحيان لما نستخدم الكتابة نستخدم الباسيف فويس في الساينتفك رايتنج, لأنه مو كويس لما تكتب شيء في الدسكشن ولا في الرسي في الميثود ولا غيره تقول I analyze ولا I wrote ولا I examined. كويس إنه تستخدم الباسيف واي, لأنه هذا more appropriate in the scientific writing. في exception معين بأشياء معينة, فرضا تبغى تحدد من السيرجن اللي سوى العملية ولا الأشياء هذه, كويس إنه تكتب وتوضح إذا كان اسم الشخص مطلوب إنه أو مهم إنه يعرف من خلال writing the manuscript. لكن إجمالاً في الـ scientific ولا academic writing, using a passive voice it is the most appropriate in a writing style of a scientific paper. شيء أخير, شيء ثاني نتكلم عنه الفيجرز والتابلز, هو أشياء مهمة تستخدم, لكن بنفس الوقت الإفراط منها or over using figures and tables will get the reader confused. So معظم الارتكل, معظم الجورنالز, they limit the number of tables and figures. الهدف من الشيء هذا اثنين, الهدف الأساسي إنه they want you to limit the figures to the most important thing that you want the reader to know or to read, and also to explain your manuscript. الشيء الثاني إذا كان في فيجر كثيرة أو تيبلز كثيرة تسوي ديستراكشن للريدر من إنه يقرأ التكست، فما يصير عنده وقت أو انطباع كويس عن الستدي وش واتس أباوت، لأنه ما قدر يقرأ التكست بشكل كامل. فاستخدام الفيجرز والتيبلز مهم، لكن لازم تستخدم بتوازن بحيث إنه الارتكل تكون متوازنة بين التكست والتيبل والفيجرز، ما يطغي حاجة عن حاجة. References is really important. It's because when you write a manuscript, you should write it based on a previous work that's been done in the area you are discussing. But you need to acknowledge them and cite their work. الشيء الثاني إنه كويس تكون up to date. يعني مو كويس تكتب references كلها قديمة بينما في أشياء جديدة بحثت أو كتبت في المجال وما ذكرت في البيبر. فالreferences كويس إنها تكون جديدة وكويس إنها تكون relevant. بعض الأحيان references تكتب reference كثيرة لكن ما هي relevant. كثير من الجورنالز حالياً they limit the number of references. ما تقدر تكتب فرضاً 100 references. لا، معظم الجورنال for example إذا كان case report يبغى لها 4 to 5 references، لأنه كويس تكون very relevant references و up to date. لما تكتب فرضاً research project it depends. بعض الجورنال يبغونها 25، بعضها أقل من 30، فتعتمد على كل جورنال وش الريكويرمنت حقتها. فكويس تكون relevant و updated. مو كويس انه يعني عدد الريفرنسز ما يعكس، مو بالضروره يعكس ان الارتكل از بيتر ولا المانوسكريبت از بيتر. فاهم شيء الكواليتي حقه الريفرنسز ومو الكوانتيتي حقه الريفرنسز. طبعا when you write a reference the references تكلم الدكتور عادي عنها قبل فتره، بس انه كويس انه you follow the journal style، لانه كل جورنال لها ستايل ان رايتنج ذا ريفرنسز. فكويس قبل ما تكتب المانوسكريبت وانت تبغى you send your article to certain journal to see what their requirement and references. ف it's good to follow their system from the start. وفي طبعا software كثير تكلم عنها الدكتور عدي قبل فترة، في المندلي واندبوينت وغيرها من الأشياء اللي ممكن تستخدم بحيث تساعدك في references وتسهل عليك the citation process. بالإضافة تسهل عليك coming back to your articles and reviewing your articles that you use to write your project. محمد كويس الوضع ولا مسرع انا شوي؟ لانه انا I'm not sure how is the speed of my talk.
لا لا good يا بروف، بس يعني احنا بنخلي وقت كمان في النهايه طويل for the discussion.
محمد
ايه تسمعني بروف؟ الو بروف تسمعني؟
محمد
can anyone hear
me؟ محمد تسمعني؟
ايوه اسمعك بروف بس يقطع شويه ما ادري تسمعني
الان؟
تسمعني بروف؟
تسمعني كويس؟
اي ممتاز بس ما اعرف
المايك عندي. اوكي طيب
المايك عندي شكله مو شغال.
طبعا بالنسبه لل
تسمح لي بروف عادل، تسمح لي بروف عادل فور انتربشن. عبد الله الفواد تسمعني؟
بروف تسمع
بالنسبه when you start writing the manuscript طبعا you start with the draft. طبعا when you start writing your draft, draft is usually it has a basic let's say basic rules and good writing elements on it. But it's good when you write your draft to check the accuracy and the logic flow of the assignment or the manuscript and put it in order. It's really important when you write your draft to highlight anything that you are unsure and you need somebody to comment on it, either can your mentor or your colleague is reviewing your draft. الشيء الثاني it's really to link when you do the draft to link the gaps together. ما تخليها الدرافت كده كل حاجة متشعبة. When you draft it's also good to your check your figures, your chart, make sure they're really relevant to what you are talking about.
بروف تسمعني؟ بروف عادل.
It's good when you write your draft is don't try not to get everything right in the first time, because the draft is about putting your idea together and try to link them together. مو شرط تكون من أول مرة واضحة والديتيلز مرة واضحة لأنه في a lot of modification you need to do during the drafting process. When you draft also you don't need to يعني start with the beginning and go till the end of your research. كويس إنه بعض خاصة أنا دائم لما نشتغل سوا مع زملاء when you start writing the manuscript, you can write the introduction and method before you get the result. ليه؟ لأنه الـ introduction والmethod هي ثابتة. فممكن تكتبها في بداية الوقت اللي أنت you are writing your result or collecting your data. You can write your introduction and your method because you have decided on this before you get out your result or even before you collecting your data. Writing an introduction will method can be started in the first or say in the first stage of your research project. شيء ثاني, when you write the draft, you need to think about your writing and make like a that you need to follow during your drafting. وخل عندك زي thought process that you need to go through. فهذا يساعدك إنه and when you draft, you draft in a nice way from the first time, so you don't need to do a lot of manipulation for your draft. شيء ثاني, when you draft, try not to be so obsessive about the writing style, expression, spelling, or grammar. You know, it needs to be done when you finish your writing the whole manuscript.
بروف تسمعني
طبعاً we'll come to after you draft, you show it to somebody else, they will edit your work and they will give it back to you. They will give it back to you and they will ask you for some comment and some consideration you need to pay attention to when you write your article. Ala Muhammad.
يعني I'm speak online.
الحين عطيتك speaker.
تقدر تسمعني الان؟
الحين مفروض ان انا unmute you.
انا I'm unmuted و I'm talking كنا حتى دكتور عبد الله he's talking to you بس انت ما بتسمعنا, ما ادري ترفع السبيكر من عندك, يمكن السبيكر عندك.
انا كنت اسمعك من قبل
والله ما ادري
اول ما بدينا
ما ادري الحين, خليني اجرب ثاني بس انه ما أوكي. ما نقدر نتكلم معك, خليني اجرب مع تسمعني الان بروف؟
And editing, you need to before you send it to somebody to edit it. It's really good to read what you have written and check all the material related to the specific point that you have put in your mind and change whenever something necessary before you send it for editing. And it's really good the time to put what's really necessary. Sometimes you put something that you think you are not sure is it necessary or not, so you put it so the one who is commenting on your work or help you in writing the manuscript can guide you, is it really something important to keep or we can omit. But drafting is the place where you put what you think it's really important to be included. The editing process comes to polish what you have written in your drafting the manuscript and detail it. It's really important when we edit the manuscript is look for what you call it repetition. مو كويس تطرح فكرة معينة وتعيدها أكثر من مرة. فكويس إنه تطرحها مرة واحدة بصياغة سلسة تكون مفهومة وما يحتاج تعيدها مرة ثانية. طبعاً we need to check for the truth or the what you call it the accuracy of your information you're presenting. We need to make sure really they are really the best to your knowledge. More ways you include something you are not sure about, either fact or numbers or figures or etc. لازم تكون really facts. شيء ثاني ممكن consistency. كويس إن تكون متجانسة مع بعض. When you write a manuscript, كويس يكون سلس ومتجانس. شيء أخير كويس تكلم when you were editing about spelling and grammar. فقبل ما ترسلها for submission, you need to check on the spelling and grammars. طبعاً الحين في softwares كثيرة can help you with spelling and grammars. من ضمنها Grammarly وغيره من software موجودة تساعدك. شيء ثاني ممكن إنه you send it for some editing websites. تساعدك to edit it, especially if they have a good medical background that help you to rephrase your statement, arranging your ideas. خاصة في البداية, في the first few manuscript you write, maybe consulting medical editors online and send them your work. It can help you to refine your sentences and also presenting how you present your data. When you finish writing your manuscript, you need to have a checklist that you make sure that you really done your best to present your work. And the checklist mainly just تتأكد إنه what you write is exactly what you want to say. Make sure about your references, are they really presented in a nice way that suit the journal style. You have submitted the manuscript to another journal and they gave you your comments, it's good to make advantage of their comments and try to include them if they really appropriate and helping your manuscript to improve the quality of your work. نقطة مهمة لازم نتكلم عنها وهذه تعتبر a cornerstone لما نتكلم عن manuscript. نتكلم عن plagiarism لأنه it's really important. Now it's becoming an issue and all journals are checking for plagiarism. لأنه if you have a plagiarism in your manuscript, they, most likely they will not consider your manuscript as a respected manuscript and they may reject it. What we mean by plagiarism is if you have your manuscript or what you are writing is written by a third party. For example, you give your result to somebody else, not part of your project, to write your article. This is called consider plagiarism. Other thing is consider plagiarism if you copied sentences and you just put them in your text without rephrasing them and without you presenting them in your own thought and your own sentences and words. That's also considered plagiarism. If you get a sentence that you want exactly to implement it in your manuscript, it's good to put it between paragraphs so people know that the statement or the sentence is taken as it is from another source. But if you are referring to another source, you need to rephrase the sentence in your own words, not to repeat what's been really written in another or the reference that you have taken your idea or your fact from. Other thing is we talk about referencing and an appropriate referencing. Plagiarism also can be really considered when a collaborative work presented and somebody else is the one writing it and taking all the advantage of the collaborative work. So if you are working with different people, it's good. It's really important to include them in your manuscript as a co-authors, not to have your name just written with ignoring the effort and the contribution of other people. طبعاً, it goes without saying if somebody did something and you write it in your with your name, so that considered plagiarism again. Another again, when you write something, it's good to acknowledge the people helping you in the project and writing their names to have all people who helped in this project to be recognized. نقطة مهمة لما نتكلم عن المانوسكريبت إنه كويس نعرف when you submit an article the editorial handling your article from the journal, they will send it to reviewers. It's really important to know what the reviewer wants, what the reviewers want, لأنه this is what gonna be the decision based on in accepting or rejecting your manuscript. But in general, the reviewer are looking for your critical thinking skills and how you analyze your data and how you make use of a previous publication and what your article or your manuscript gonna add to the literature. You know, this is really important to have your article accepted. Another thing they are looking at is your writing skills. Is your writing, is your manuscript writing is fluent, consistent, easy to understand, and presenting your work in an appropriate way, or it's exaggerated or mixed up or confused. That's really another important thing. Also, they want to see if your outcome are achieved or not. So in your introduction, you put certain outcomes. Is your manuscript or conclusion is achieving your outcome or not? And also they will look for the appropriate referencing. In another way, for me, the way I look at it, when you write a manuscript, it's like in a product or something you have created, and you want people to like your product. So it's good to put it in the best way possible for people to get, interested in your product. But it's good to present it in a nice way, to try to see what the thing that can be added or gonna be positive in your manuscript and stress on it, and what's negative, try to avoid it as much as possible, or try to present it in a nice way that will be accepted to the reviewer without changing the facts and without changing or manipulating the data. Because this is really, really important to be honest when you present your work and try to be really presenting exactly what you have done and what you have found. It's another important thing I want to stress is the discussion part, because the discussion part is the place where you do your critical thinking and present your idea and your main outcome of your study and what you want people to understand from your study. So that's really, really important. And when you write it, it needs to be logic. When you discuss something, you need to present the reason, and you need to present, for example, the pros and cons of your manuscript or your work.
بروف تسمعني؟ بروف تسمعني؟ بروف عادل. Everyone else, can anyone hear me?
ايوه محمد نسمعك، محمد نسمعك، بس هو يبدو لي ما يسمعنا.
خليني اقول للبروف يطلع ويرجع ثاني.
هلا بحاول بس اسوي لي كم ميوت ماني عارف.
خليني اقترح عليك يا بروف اطلع من خلصت المحاضره اطلع من
لا باقي الجون
طيب تبغى تطلع وترجع ثاني لان عشان نبغى ندي وقت كمان
للاسئله. بس بخليها ويل تاتش ان ذا جورنال سيلكشن بعدين وي كان جو وات يو ثينك.
طيب خلاص اوكي جو هيد. طيب خلاص ماشي وبعدين تطلع وترجع ثاني خلاص ماشي بروف تسلم ماشي.
طبعا بس كل ما اخيرا نتكلم عن الجورنال سيلكشن when you write a manuscript and your project not all journals will be interested in your project there in each subspecialty for example نتكلم عن الاكلوبلاستي if you're writing something about echoblast and you present it in some in a journal not interested in that one, for example, cornea, they will not accept it. So it's good to know what are the scope of each journal and what things that you think may be interested or may attract their attention to be published in their journal. There is some journals are general, for example, ophthalmology, British Journal of Ophthalmology, and etc. They accept it from all the subspecialty. Or all the specialty. And when they accept, they want something that will be, let's say, either breakthrough, and it's really important, or a topic that is it's good for a general ophthalmologist. Like if you're talking about something very specific, very advanced in glaucoma, for example, you need to present it to a glaucoma journal because that will be the interest of the readers in that journal. If you're talking about something more general, more generalized about glaucoma and all ophthalmologists across the subspecialty they would be interested on, you can submit it to the ophthalmology or British Journal of Ophthalmology or American Journal of Ophthalmology where their interest is more generalized. Other thing, if when you get your research or your work presented in a meeting or a scientific meeting, some of the meeting they require you to submit a manuscript to them and they have the first right for refusal of your manuscript. For example, if your work been accepted the American Academy of Ophthalmology, you have to submit your work to ophthalmology. Either, for example, you submit your work and get it the oral presentation and ASOBRAS, for example, American Society for Ophthalmic Plastic Reconstructive Surgery, you have to submit your work to the OBRS to get the first, they call it the first right of refusal. But madam, when you submit, when they get it accepted, you have to submit it, the manuscript to them. بعض الأحيان, that's a good sign when you get your manuscript, your research project accepted in a meeting, that most likely they're gonna accept your manuscript when you submit it to the journal, link to that meeting. Another point, if you are submitting your manuscript, your work to another meeting or any meeting in general, that means people are interested in your work, and that is a good sign that when you submit your manuscript and you write it in an appropriate way that the journal may accept it. So that's a good indicator that your work really people are interested to read and know about. When you select a journal, it's good to look for the strength and novelty of your study. For example, if you are presenting a retrospective study that talking about population in Saudi Arabia, if you submit it to a journal that is in Asia, for example, they will not be that interested about it. So, but if you submit it to a Saudi Journal of Ophthalmology or a journal in the region, they will be interested about it. Other thing is when you want to your work to be submitted in a very prestigious or respected journal, usually they look for the novelty of your work. Is it some adding really as a positive or a new fact to the literature or not? And also they will look at the style of your study. If you are doing, for example, randomized clinical trial, or you are doing a high hierarchy of study, they will accept and will accept your journal. But if you are doing a retrospective study and something that's been studied in several papers before and you wanted to get published in ophthalmology, they will not accept that one. Other thing you need to consider when you submit your work to the journal is to look for the review process. Some of the journal, they're taking so long time to get you back the answer. And these journals, good to keep them at the end, not to submit your work initially to them. Some of the journals, they give you the feedback within 2 to 3 weeks. And these good journals to start with, because if they get accepted, usually you will get your published. But if you don't, if they haven't accepted your work, you have a chance to go for another journal. It's really important to get your work published as soon as possible, because if somebody else with a similar date have get their work published ahead of you, the journal will not be interested to repeat what has been published in the literature before. So that's really important to keep in mind. Another really important thing when you consider submitting your work to another journal, to look at the impact factor of your journal. You look what for the ISI factor, because the higher ISI factor, the more impact your work will have in the scientific community. And it's really important to have your work really read. And it's really important for you have been working in something, and good people to make use of that. And the best way for you to have your work public read and being let's say utilized to publish in a very respected journal. And this is in brief in how you select your journal. And this is the end of my presentation. So maybe I will go out and I will.
بروف تسمعني ولا I think he will go out now. So I encourage everyone to send their questions to the chat. هلا بروف. طيب أنا موجود خلاص دحين بس أنت تحتاج تدخل تعال نضغط اللينك وجوين again. طيب.
محمد
تفضل دكتور عبد الله
يعني الان البروف عادل will come back will rejoin us again
لا he's joining he's ايش بروف طيب تسمعني اوكي خلاص open your camera عشان اقدر اشوفك بس تطلع ايوه تفضل دكتور عبد الله اي تسمعني يا بروف عادل Let me unmute you. Okay.
أيوة أسمعك الحين.
أي تمام التمام. دكتور عبد الله.
يعطيك العافية بروف عادل and thank you for this illustration. أعتقد إنه محمد this is the time for discussion. If you allow me of few things to ask بروف عادل about. طبعا في one question ظاهر من وليد or somebody saying. Know which journal you will target whenever you finish your paper. And I think you mentioned this already, you know, based on the topic, the kind of subspecialized topic, you'll go for subspecialty journals. And if it is general topic, you will go for the general journals. Is that true, Prof. Adel?
I agree with you totally. هذا شيء. وشيء ثاني مهم, it depends on the strength of your study. طبعا if you are presenting something you think it's for example not being discussed before or novel you will target a very prestigious journal if you presenting something that been like studied previously in several articles the prestigious journal will not accept your work but as you mentioned exactly it depends on the specialty and also the novelty and the strength of your study
طبعا هذه جنرال انفورميشن للزملاء جميعا. طبعا بروسبكتيف ستدي ويل بي سترونجر تو بي اكسبتد بوزيتيف ريزلت موستلي they look for it. يعني حتى ولو كانوا الجورنالز يسينج بس موستلي they look for positive. فلذلك طريقة العرض of your paper and result is important to show the positive result. حتى لو كان فيها نيجاتيف زي ما تفضل بروف عادل, you need to mention it, لكن the highlight will be about the positive في الابستراكت and for the conclusion.
اسمعني الآن بروف.
أيوة اسمعك.
اي في سؤال برضو اذا سمحت دكتور عبد الله كذلك. sometimes احنا نبدا ب
الشيء الاخر يعني اسمع
صوتك يقطع دكتور عبد الله.
يبدو لي في مشكله في الكونكشن
الانترنت هو بطيء يعني اتوقع
تفضل جود
اي بس the questions اللي دائما نسأل should I choose my journal قبل ما أبدأ أكتب المانوسكريبت ولا أكتب المانوسكريبت and then I'll go ahead and choose my journal. لأنه when you go to the each journal the authors guidelines في الجورنالز مختلفة عن بعض الأحيان, وأحيانا you formulate your manuscript بناء على journal محدد والجورنال الثاني تقريبا المانوسكريبت a little bit مختلف عن الجورنال هذا. وهنا تدخل الديليمة يعني if I choose I formulate my manuscript بناء على journal وبعدين قدمت عليه I have to reformulate it again for another journal. Which is which يعني which is do you prefer to, أبدأ بالjournal selection وأشوف إيش الجورنز اللي أبغاه وبناء عليه أسوي المانوسكريبت ولا أسوي المانوسكريبت and then أبدأ أشوف الجورنز الموجودة.
طبعا محمد بالنسبة للjournal requirement غالبا متشابهة, يعني قليل جدا تلقى فرق شاسع بين الجورنال والجورنال. معظم الاحيان الفرق يكون بالنمبر اوف ووردز, فرضا لما نتكلم عن الاوفثالمولوجي النمبر اوف ووردز فور اكزامبل ان المين ستادي لازم ما تزيد عن 2500 نفرض الاشياء, يعني هي غالبا تكون في النمبر اوف ووردز والريفرنسنج ستايل بيكون بسيطه. لكن معظم الجورنال متقاربه جدا يعني ناي خاصه في الاوفثالمولوجي معظمها متجانسه, يعني ما تلقى فرق كبير بين الريكويرمنت حق الاوفثالمولوجي والريكويرمنت حق بريتش جورنال اوفثالمولوجي نفرض. بس اللهم اذا ممكن شيء بسيط في الابستراكت في الاشياء يعني اشياء دي فاين ديتيلز ذات كان بي ايزي تو فيكس وذين ا داي, فما اتوقع ان زين ايشو
اوكي.
تسمح لي بروف عادل محمد قلت لي ماي استراتيجي ان تاكلينج ذس I usually زي ما تفضل بروف عادل إن if I think this paper is publishable in a highly impacted journal, وأعتقد إن الwork I spend a lot of time on it, يعني mostly it will not be a case report or something. فI usually target the main journals with high impact factor, mostly يعني American Journal of Ophthalmology, British Journal of Ophthalmology, يعني اللي هي الQ1. وممكن يعني we can show what do we mean by Q1 and Q2 and Q3 and you formulate your abstract according to that your formulate abstract and manuscript according to that. The beauty of them زي ما تفضل بروف عادل انهم usually they will reply to you immediately and in a lot of times they will give you some comment. احيانا reviewers they will give you some comment حتى لو انهم they rejected, so you can fix your journal and then you fix your manuscript and then you go back and look for the Q2 or Q1 Q3 journals to submit it. ودائما يعني كويس انها تكون متقاربه, يعني صحيح زي ما تفضل دكتور عادل انها يعني بالعاده تكون يعني متقاربه in 80%, بس 20% if you want you can look for them. بالعاده تكون يعني احيانا same publisher يكونون قريبين من الفورمات حقتها, بس this is not a big deal, يعني حتى لو كان تعديل بسيط it will not be a big deal.
طيب allow me to take one question or two بعدين I'll go to one of the questions main discussions اللي معايا. طيب احنا ردينا على سؤال وليد برضو, you can have a look at the chat prof
اذا تقدر. ايوه في سؤال من راكان about review articles. طبعا في journals their main target or their main style is review articles, زي فرضا current opinion ophthalmology اشياء زي كذا, this is what they really interested in. بالنسبة للبيج جورنالز اللي they mix up a few articles مع for example research project case presentation they accept without invitation مو ضروري invitation لها بس غالبا they when they review and when they accept a few articles they want it from like somebody expert in the field to review to be a part of the authorship. The review after doesn't need to be by invitation, لا. But you know, sometimes they invite or they intentionally they want somebody who's really experienced in that let's say topic to be a co-author in the manuscript.
تمام. في سؤال برضو قبل الدكتورة كان الدكتورة نوران باديب تقول Do you have any experience in publishing in journals that are interested in medical education? And ophthalmology, and do you recommend any?
معظم الأشياء اللي we publish can for ophthalmology. We try to submit something about residency training to one of the European Journal of Medical Education. We didn't get lucky to get it accepted. So I haven't submit other than that one.
في journals يعني متخصصة في medical education. You can target them. و among ophthalmology, the Canadian Journal of Ophthalmology, sometimes they publish something related to education and related to residency. Maybe they would be interested to join to accept yours.
Okay, so I'll go to the participant or the mic or raise hand. وبعدين أرجع للشات عشان ندي الجميع فرصة. طيب فيصل الراشد. Unmute you to ask your question.
السلام عليكم بروف.
السلام ورحمة الله. هلا فيصل.
يا هلا والله. حياك بروف. واضح صوتي؟
واضح جدا.
اي بس سؤالي يا بروف. If I want to publish in يعني one journal from the beginning, let's say I'm targeting a Q1 journal for يعني a good research project. Do you recommend citing that some articles from the same journal? يعني I'm hearing about this, but I'm not sure. Is it يعني will it make a difference or no?
I'm not aware that it makes a difference. I don't think so.
Sometimes it does. صحيح فيصل. Sometimes it does. خاصة للجورنالز اللي ما يعني highly impacted.
واضح جدا دكتور.
وإحنا يعني لعنا المرة الجاية يعني السيشن اللي بيقوله الآن الدكتور محمد maybe we can ask the editors and we clarify some of these topics.
يعطيكم العافية دكتور.
طيب نايف السليمان. بروف مين وايل لم تيكن كويشن كان يو إليبوريت مور على موضوع الكيو 1 والكيو 2 الفيرست كوارتايل والسكند جورنالز والامباكت فاكتور بالنسبه للجورنالز
طبعا الامباكت فاكتورز هذه ديبندز ان سايتيشن في الاوفثالمولوجي طبعا الاوفثالمولوجي مو اتس نوت ا بيج سبيشاليتي كومبير تو ميديسن بيدياتريك اور سيرجري بالعاده السايتيشن في الاوفثالمولوجي ما تكون مره عاليه ممكن الأوفثالمولوجي well respected prestigious journals تلقاها فرضا أوفثالمولوجي one of the known in clinical في أشياء في الريسيرش في الأوفثالمولوجي تصل 9 حولها لكن معظم الجورنالز اللي نعتبرها respected في الأوفثالمولوجي يكون impact factor 5-4 that's considered really good impact factor even higher but most of the subspecialty journals except of retina يعني لما تكلم عن الجلوكوما الكلوبلاستي بيدياتريك الامباكت فاكتور تكون between 1 to 2 فما it's not that high because of the number of citation is less and number of people interested in that subspecialty is less but being not being a high impact factor for the subspecialty that expect something accepted لانه the number of citation will be less لكن زي الأوفثالمولوجي British Journal of Ophthalmology American Journal of Ophthalmology because as a general a number of citation is higher so impact factor is high
okay so
محمد أنا I send you a link if you can share it with the others أحيانا بعض المواقع يعني related to your question تعطيك يعني like an overview about the journal يعني تكتب الجورنال تعطيك كم الإمباكت حقها وتعطيك كم الكيو in which queue, Q1 or Q2 or Q3, وأحيانا برضو تعطيك how easy you publish, يعطيك زي الجدول أنه it is يعني medium difficulty or easy to be published, يعني يعطيك حتى in average how many weeks they will reply to you, ويعطونك برضو rejection rate. فهذه أحيانا تكون مساعدة, يعني certain website will give you the, you put the name of the journal and can give you a review about it. برضو Web of Science يعطيك اللي هي قضية الإمباكت حقها و how indexed is the journal. برضو هذه كويسة for promotions.
If you allow us, Prof, كمان to take a few more minutes, إذا وقتك يسمح to tackle...
ما عندي مشكلة, بس محمد في comments بغيت أتكلم عنها لأنه طرحت من ضمن الأسئلة وكان كويس. طبعاً when you write manuscript, أنا I recommend عادة الناس تبدأ بcase report. يعني just to get in a mood of scientific writing. بعدين ممكن they write review article زي ما اقترح الدكتور خالد المالكي. وبعدين you go for your own project. فit's good to start with something simple. Just to get started, but then you go step by step. But that's a good strategy and something really I recommend a lot. يعني لما يجي فرضا يجيني intern يقول أبغى أكتب study, أقول له عاد أبدأ بcase reports just to taste the scientific writing. ممكن go another step after case report with the literature review. That's a good start صراحة in writing in a scientific or academic writing.
Okay, so في سؤال هنا جانا private. Is it possible to publish the same paper in two different journals to target the two different audience? This is not allowed as far as you know. It's one of the main conditions اللي موجودة في كل الجورنالز.
هي plagiarism. This is a plagiarism. بس في نقطة محمد كويس إنه مدام طرح السؤال هذا. بعض الأحيان you do a project and you can publish two or three articles talking about different things. بمعنى يعني من الأشياء اللي سويناها إنه we did a CT scan for patient post orbital decompression and we found that the muscle size is different after decompression and also we find the eye position is different after decompression. But in one article we talk about the change in eye position, in another article we talk about the muscle changes after decompression. But if you are talking about different ideas or different messages or different results, it's okay. If it's not repeating the same result, that's really important. واضح محمد؟
أيوة واضح النقطة من
النقطة. بس اسمح لي بس كومنت, يعني هذه برضو أنا ذكرت برضو البروف عادل قبل شيء في البرزنتيشن was saying إنه أحيانًا you can publish sorry you present something in the conferences and then you can publish it. يعني this is a nice idea, but then I just want to alert the people and know once you publish it or you يعني present it in a conference, you need to mention this or you need to acknowledge it and if you are submitting the paper later on. فلذلك يعني هذه يحتاج أن تأخذ بعين الاعتبار. It is the same idea and you cannot publish in two different journals.
وهذه نقطة ممتازة دكتور عبد الله ذكرتها. بعض الأحيان if you say this, that will increase the chance of your acceptance.
Yeah.
So to recognize that people are interested to see your work or read your project.
What section of the journal يعني you write this? So you write this in the في ال conflict of interest مثلا تقول this journal was published in or was presented in specific meeting ولا فين؟
كل journal لها requirement وين تكتب فيها. بعض الأحيان تكتبها بالcover letters, بعض الأحيان تكتبها it depends on the journal, so the instructing authors will tell you where to write it because each journal is different.
Mostly in the acknowledgement يا محمد. Most of the time you write it in the acknowledgement. بالمناسبة يعني the people who is with us in the department who is facing some difficulty في قضية writing and submitting. In the research unit, we have people to help you in submitting and giving you instructions. And we have three secretary in the research unit. They can help you in submitting. إذا كان أحد من الزملاء عنده مشكلة في قضية submission والinstruction to authors أو كذا, you can approach them and they will help you. طبعاً the head of the unit is Prof. Yasser الفقي. He's having three nurse secretary that they can help in submission.
Okay. I'll go to the quickly to the raised hand. Naif Sleiman, you have a question. I'll unmute you. تفضل يا نايف.
السلام عليكم.
عليكم السلام.
عليكم السلام.
الله يعطيك ألف عافية بروف. Very informative talk. You spoke about the part about choosing the article. فأنا بستغل وجودك ووجود دكتور عبد الله. And my question is about the case reports. يعني is there a way to know which articles are more interested in case reports rather than main articles? Because some residents face difficulties in choosing articles who are interested more in case reports. My question is about the publication of the case report. ما أدري تقدر تفيدنا من ناحية هذه أنت دكتور عبد الله. أقول لكم شاكر.
أنت قصدك جورنال يا نايف صح؟ More journals more interested in a case report صحيح؟
بالضبط. Yes yes.
اتفضل.
طبعاً أنا بمناسبة منطلق من my specialty في الأكلوبلاستي العادة we send يعني if we have a case report I send it to OBRS ophthalmic plastic reconstructive surgery they have a section for case reports بعض الأحيان الأوربت في بعض الأحيان journals specific يعني their main interest is a case report ف we can these are the journals you can target طبعاً غالباً البيج جورنال زي الافثالمولوجي بريتش جورنال افثالمولوجي امريكان جورنال افثالمولوجي they are not accepting case reports anymore because they are focusing more on research project or some review articles or editorials but still some journals still they accept like OBRS Orbit and زي ما قلنا قبل شوي في journals their main focus is a case reports and these are the journals that you target
اسمح لي
محمد
just comment on this when I صحيح انه يعني زي ما تفضل بروف most of the journals are not accepting much على الاقل الفتره الماضيه يعني اخر مثلا 10 سنوات و 1 decade كانت في اشكاليه في publishing لكن recently in the last 2 or 3 years في كثير من المين جورنالز صاروا يحطون sub journal for case report و I'm seeing it increasing ف you can look for them يعني in multiple journals and you will find it as specializing case report طبعا from Q2 and Q3 the case report is easy to publish لكن if you are يعني going to Q1 mostly it will be difficult to publish a case report in there لكن زي ما تفضل البروف عادل يعني if you are starting with a case report وحتى للزملاء والزميلات اللي معانا من الفرق يعني junior level من residency يعني there are يعني دائما research is good to test and to know your skills فبدأك في البدايات يعني publish it in any available journal and then in the future you can target more and be more skillful in writing that will يعني will have higher chance to be published in prestigious journals.
يعطيكم العافية شكرا جزيلا.
طيب I'll take the last four questions من الشات وخلاص ما نتك from the no raised hand. So Dr. Khaled Al-Malki is saying, what are the initial steps to write a review article and tips to target a good topic?
طبعاً بالنسبة للreview articles, يعني you need to go and read in all, let's say, all articles that's really relevant and important in your topic. So you need to write to read them so you can summarize them in your review articles. So you need to read really extensive when you want to write review articles. في حاجة اسمها matrix or literature review matrix. ممكن I can share it later on. زي a table you make and you put the study that you have been across, you came across, and you put criteria for each study. Is it, for example, a prospective study? Is it a retrospective study? Is it RTC or what is it exactly? And that will help you to weigh your articles or your literature you have been gone through. Then you can write your manuscript after that. But really, you need to read first a lot of about it. And the other thing is really good to know what's the style of the journal you are writing the review articles to, because يعني some of each journal has a special way of having your review articles written. يعني لما تكون for example you write for current opinion ophthalmology they want the review article in a certain style if you go to OBRS they want it to a certain style so you need to know what's the style after a few articles, they want you to present your review article in, and you start from there.
Okay, that's great. I'll take it from you, Prof. The whole matrix table. I can send it and share it with everyone.
اسمح لي بس محمد كومنت على الموضوع هذا الريفيو زي ما تفضل بروف يعني تز one of the difficult to يعني انك تصير ملم فيه الجميع يعني وهو من الاشياء اللي يعني اصلا ideally it's supposed to be invited really for يعني to have it يعني real review it is good to start it يعني ما في against that to do it لكن if you are going to do a review article target a small topics. يعني for instance في الكورنيا you don't go for مثلا keratoconus. That will be so difficult to يعني target. لكن انت ممكن you can go keratoconus with vernal keratoconjunctivitis. Association between them. This can you تستطيع انك تلم فيه من ناحية فلذلك if you go for small topic you can do it in a good way. وزي ما تفضل بروف عادل يعني usually you target a new articles. You don't go for old articles. It can show you any landmark paper.
Okay, so now question from ZY. Is it mandatory to add سؤال عن الauthorship. Is it mandatory to add surgeon, radiologist and pathologist to the authorship even though they are not contributing to the paper? هذا سؤال أعتقد بروف عادل أكيد يمر عليك كثير لأنه pathology دائما involved in your
study. وهذه الإشكالية أنه how to avoid conflict with the colleagues. وأكبر من هذه مشكلة كمان أنه لما if you have a research team وفي بعض الممبرز they are not contributing at all وترسل الارت المانوسكريبت لهم وما يردون عليك بكومنتس يعني هذه مشكلة أكبر كمان. You have to be diplomatic in answering this. How you tackle this? How is your relationship with your colleagues? Lakin if you talk scientifically, يعني معظم ال respected journal they want what the author's contribution. For example, main first author, what did they contribute to the project? Second author, third author, etc. Lakin being a surgeon that you did this procedure. Without being part of the study, it's not qualifying. Or being a pathologist, because this is your routine work. It's not something related to the project. But by the hand, you can have conflict. There is no like right or wrong answer. Like in, for my opinion, it's good to see your relationship with other people. يعني فيها لازم شوي فيها دبلوماسية. لكن زي ما قلت لك, scientifically, مفروض إنه يكون they have really actively contributed. يعني نفرض انه احنا في الجامعه والبروف ياسر بيسوي ستدي عن توسس ومن ضمن الاشياء اللي سواها سوى ريفيو للشارت اللي سويناها ان لما اذا راجع الحالات اللي سويتها انا وانا I'm not part of the study I should not be included هو يعني I should not be an author in this manuscript or this research project if I'm not contributing actively in the project itself. يعني being a surgeon in a case that is routine my work to do, it's not qualifying. نفس الكلام ينطبق على radiologists والphotographer والhomopher is doing their routine work. And this is my opinion.
صحيح. في authorship, يعني there are a lot of papers written on the authorship who is qualified to have authorship. ولها guidelines, يعني موجودة حتى on the website from Harvard. You have يعني papers to say هو qualified بس ما تفضل بروف عادل يعني احيانا فيها شيء من السياسه والمواربه والبعض الاشياء اللي يعني ما فيها وايت اند بلاك بعض الاشياء واضحه وبعض الاحيان لا فيها something مشترك.
I shared I came across an article talking about في الامريكان جورنال اوف كاس ريبورت talking about author statement with examples عليها. I shared the link with them here. So a question from Dr. Anadal Madi saying, thank you, Prof. Adil. As you said, novelty matters to all journals. But if someone had a study that stratified the data in their region for whatever pathology, disease, procedure, and its complications. Saudi, for example, knowing that it had been discussed in the literature previously, but in different region or country, would this weaken the chance of it getting accepted? The fact being repetitive, يعني مثلاً إنك we have someone did an a project in their country, you want to do the same project in your country. Would this weaken the chance of getting it accepted, the fact being repetitive?
Depends. It may be gonna be attractive to the journal in the region. يعني فرضاً لما study for example كراتي كونس in Saudi Arabia, the prevalence in the certain part of the country, that will be interested in the Saudi Journal of Ophthalmology, will be interested in that. Some big journal may be interested in this, especially if they have international section. يعني زي فرضاً the British Journal of Ophthalmology, they have international section. They may be interested in that one too. So it doesn't know, be studying a prevalence or a disease behavior that it's been proven to be different from one population to another, it's not something weakening the study, no. It will be interesting for people to know about.
Another question from Raghad Rashid. Some journals ask you to choose potential reviewers. Any tip or points we need to be aware of when choosing reviewers for our article?
طبعا الشيء مهم when you read when you mention reviewers or choose كويس you choose people they reply then we should see if you mention somebody who is not replying quickly that will delay your publication another thing you see you choose people who whom they trust you because part of the reviewing process is to know if this data done in a proper way and the study was done in a proper way or not. And this is another really important thing. Sometimes some journals, they want to get their manuscript or paper published because X person was part of that study or Y person was part of that study because they know that really they are good and really meticulous in their work. They know you, they know that you're really doing a good work. Then they respond fast. If they are really taking long time, it will be delaying you a lot.
برضو I came across, ما أدري if you mentioned, Prof, حتى in some journals, they ask you if you prefer someone not to review your manuscript. You can mention this, actually, in the...
True.
Yeah.
If there is conflict of interest, maybe. أيوه.
بس في موضوع على هذه another way اذا انك يعني اذا غلقت الابواب ما عاد استطعت انك تجد يعني ريفيور ان ذير از وان جود تيب انه الريفرنس اوف يور ارتكل بعضهم احيانا يكون ميجر somebody who is يعني working in that field for multiple articles ف maybe this will be a good potential to commend or recommend him as a reviewer.
جميل. طيب خلاص نختم بهذا السؤال بروف براكتيكال كويشن فور يو اذا دكتور عبد الله سمحني يور سيلف بروف when you finish your manuscript what do you do for plagiarism what program do you use what is your experience with it what whom do you ask to help you with linguistic والارت وورك والفيجرز والامور هذه كلها هل تخلي احد يراجعها او ترسل في خدمات احيانا في الجورنال زي البروف ريدنج ياخذوا الجورنال يصلحوا لك فيه اشياء يقول لك لا تو بي اكسبتد لازم الفيجر يكون بهذا الشكل وهذا الشكل حتى although you follow the guidelines احيانا عندهم بس you have to pay واحيانا يكون expensive from a practical point of view once you finish your manuscript proof هل استخدمت grammarly yourself هل whom do you ask for linguistics
هو صراحة أول ما بديت أكتب كنت أستخدم كثير exceptional English لأنه كنت أعرف اللي ماسك الويب سايت هذا مو دعاية لا لأن الحين قفل الويب سايت أصلاً في أول تقريباً let's say 20 articles I wrote I sent it to them they helped me a lot in rearranging the word the statement الأشياء هذه بالنسبة للبلاجيريزم كنت استخدم جرامر لفترة بس الحين خلاص يعني when I write it myself I rephrase things I know that is not gonna be picked up لكن if you are really in doubt Grammarly is a good program which is free and you can download it for free and use it طبعا if you want the premium option you need to pay for it
Yeah.
من ناحية الـ English proofing, I try to do it myself as much as possible. في عندنا في الـ department زي ما تفضل الدكتور عبد الله قبل شوي, في people can help in this, بس إنه نادرا جدا أرسلها يعني الآن for like somebody to review the English because we have been writing good number of papers, so I know what's how you get that done.
تمام بروف. طيب بحكم انك از اوكيلوبلاستي دائما في صور, يو اولويز سبميت فوتوز, يو اولويز سبميت سي تي سكان, يو اولويز سبميت باثولوجي سلايدز, واحيانا اتس يطلبوا كده دقه محدده وعمل محدد ويبغاها ان سيبريت فايلز. هل في طريقه يعني, لانه احيانا وانس يو سبميت خلاص ما في رجعه, مثلا حيرسل يعني this will delay your review more and more اذا كنت you're not following the guidelines. هل في طريقه عن طريق الجورنال نفسه يا بروف تطلب منهم انهم يراجعوها من غير سبميشن, يعني نفس الجورنال تقول لهم هذه تتوافق مع 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 ما تريدون او احتاج اعدلها؟
اي هذا اللي يصير محمد, انه you can email them, they are open for editorial assistant, you can email them for this. هذا الشيء. شيء ثاني, نفس ال when you submit it initially أكثر ما مرة يرجعوني إياها إنه والله ال figure resolution ما كان واضح, والفيديو wasn't appropriate, wasn't matching our requirement, فيرجعوا لك إياها قبل ما يرسلوا لها للreviewer يعني.
Okay.
وإديتنج قليل يكون فيه مشكلة صح. الآن مع النيو مع الفوتوز وال يعني البروغرامز اللي فيلبل والهاي تك ما قليل يكون فيه مشكلة حالي. هذا الكلام من زمان, لكن حاليا الحمد لله ما كنت واجهت مشكله.
محمد اسمح لي في النقطه هذه. يوجوالي وين يو سبميتد طبعا في انستراكشن تو اوثر يقول لك حتى الديسيبل يعني ريزولوشن مكتوبه يعني ات از اوريدي ريتن. بالاضافه انه وانس ات از فينيش ريفيوينج وببلش يعني اتس اباوت تو بي ببلشد يرسلون لك اياه فور يعني ابروفل قبل وذ ذا فاينل فورمات وابروف. لو لاحظت ان الصوره فيها اشكال او كذا يو كان يعني alert them, او اللي هم حتى احيانا يقول لك يا والله احنا this is the fine بس ان البيكتشر اور ذات تيبل از نوت كلير يو نيد تو سند ات باك تو اس. فهم they are checking this, هم حريصين برضو على موضوع resolution.
جميل جدا.
في موضوع الايديتنج بس اذا تسمحوا لي, موضوع الايديتنج يعني زي ما تفضل البروف, انا يعني I published my first paper with دكتور مايكل واغنر, ومايكل واغنر is a native يعني English language writer وكذا, and he recommended me to do this. فذلك أنا would recommend people who is doing their early articles and to send it for proofreading و professional editing as much as they can. طبعا الآن حتى الببليشر يعني مثل Elsevier والبعض ال they have website to do that. طبعا that will not increase your acceptance rate, لكنها it will definitely improve your language وتخلي القبول والقراءة لها أفضل. Yes.
يعتقد الخطوات الأولى دائما في أول publication تدفع فيها كثير عشان تتعلم وتستخدم يعني different journals different ASF programs, يعني تستفيد منها كثير. فيعني encourage people حتى to try it. حتى أعتقد premium Grammarly يسألني هنا محمد العتيبي do you recommend getting premium Grammarly. أعتقد بلاجيريزم بعد 15-20% من الارتكل more words needs a premium section. أنا I promised you now I will not take any more questions. دكتور إيمان الشريف عندك question, do you want me to take that or to conclude here؟
لا بس من ناحية الـ open access it's, يعني if you want your article to be read more it's good to pay for it, يعني ما, nothing to be against it صراحة. فما هي it depends on what you like to have. If you like people to approach your article easily, you need to pay for this. هذه من ناحية open access or not to have it open access article. لا خلاص. بس أنا عندي كلمة بالأخير إذا خلص بس تعطيني المجال بس أقولها وبعدها.
طيب حاضر. معناته I will take Iman's questions. تقول thanks for the great talk and thanks all for valuable contributions. Some good journals give you option of publishing your work as open access article and they ask you to pay fees. Is it better to go for this option? شد خلاص انت you tackle this question already.
Yeah.
Of Iman. And I meant for payment, ما اقصد على ال open or close اللي قال عليها البروف هادي. This is to for people to get your articles more or cited more. لأن اقصد على انك you pay and جرب Grammarly, ادفع for proofreading, test all these options. In the future, you will know what to use and what not. يعني at least from my experience, my opinion. طيب, by this we conclude our session. وأعطي بروف عادل few minutes to conclude. الله يعطيك العافية. تفضل بروف. شكرا على وقتك.
دكتور محمد، بس أول شيء حبيت أشكرك وأشكر الدكتور عبد الله على putting this together. من ناحية يعني يعني خلال السنوات الماضية صار لي فرصة أشتغل مع زملاء كثير من ناحية writing manuscript. الحمد لله في عدد كبير جدا من الزملاء كان مرة impressive. ليه؟ لأنهم أول شيء they have a good writing skills. They have the passion for it. وغير كذا they spend effort in writing the manuscript. بعض الزملاء ما يصرفون وقت كفاية، وهذا يأثر على السوبرفايزر. يعني فرضا مدام أنا في أسماء هنا ودي أذكرها وأشكرها لأنه really they were really good from the first time، الدكتور نايف سليمان، الدكتورة إيمان الشريف، ويعني اكتبوا حاجة بعد ما تعبوا عليها. يعني ما يصلك الدرافت إلا بعد ما يكون هو تعب عليه فعلا لما جاي كتبه. بعض الزملاء الآخرين يعطوك درافت يعني أوكي برسل لك معلومات وأنت دكتور ضبطها. هذه يعني تخلي السوبرفايزر والنفس somebody is helping you ما will not be that motivated to finish his work quickly. يعني إذا جاني manuscript متعوب عليه ما يأخذ مني وقت أراجعه وأعطي my comments في وقت قصير. لكن إذا جاني manuscript or draft فيه عجن وغث كثير هذا بياخذ مني وقت طويل فبيأخر البروسس. فشيء مهم قبل ما ترسل المانسكريبت ولا الدرافت للريفيو للسوبرفايزر تأكد انه بذلت فيه مجهود كبير، وتأكد انه يعني ترسله كانك بترسل الارتكل للسبمشن، وهذا يساعد البروسس ويفتح شهيه نفس السوبرفايزر تو جيف كومنتس. إذا فرضاً نفس المانسكريبت أو الدرافت كان فيه أشياء كثيرة تتعدل بحمل هم أن يسوي الشيء هذا، لكن لما يكون فيه أشياء بسيطة أنها تتعدل بيساعدني أكثر ويجيف يو مور ريفاينمنت بمقابل أنه لما أسوي تغيير مرة كبير في المانسكريبت أو في الدرافت. فشيء مهم أنه تبذل مجهود قبل ما ترسل لأحد صراحة.
جميل جداً. دكتور عبد الله، do you have any addition or shall we end the night؟
لا بالعكس، thank you very much and thank you بروف عادل for his time. يعني احنا we squeeze him in his trip، لكن يعني thank you very much. It was very informative. والله يعطيك الصحة والعافية وترجع بالسلامة ان شاء الله.
الله يسلمك، شكرا جميعا.
شكرا لكم جميعا، الله يعطيكم العافية. We expect you ان شاء الله next week. We will have one of the editor in chief دكتور علي الراجحي to walk us through the journey after submission. Once you submit, هذا العالم الآخر اللي ما تدري عنه في الجورنال، where you will see how the reviewers look at your article, what do they need, how they would reply, what takes so long, what takes short for reply. So we are expecting you all there, inshallah. شكرا لكم جميعا الحضور. Thank you, دكتور فواد. Thank you, بفعادل, for your time. نراكم على خير جميعا إن شاء الله.
السلام.